Guys, we have a few books for you today to read the passages of various things and to talk about a little bit. The Drummers of Jerhicho, that's by Carolyn Mayer. And that's The Drummers of Jerhicho, about a young girl, a Jewish girl, that goes to to be with her father and is in a non-Jewish environment, and she wants to keep to her Jewish roots. We'll talk about that soon. The Drummers of Jerhicho, The Short Life of Sophie Scholl by Hermann Vink, translated from the German by Hedwig Pastor. That's about a young German girl who went against Nazi Germany. She went against them, and she tried to do what she could to protest the Nazis and to try to save Jews. The Short Life of Sophie Scholl. Then we have, if we can get to it, The Cantor's Daughter, stories by Scott Nadelson. Stories by Scott Nadelson. We'll talk about that. Okay, one moment. Let me just do something here. We'll get to our... We'll start out here. The Drummers of Jerhicho. The Drummers of Jerhicho by Carolyn Mayer. We'll read from the flaps and we'll talk about it. This is from the outside cover. Quote, go ahead, open it. Not knowing what to expect, Billy gingerly lifted the lid of the white box, which looked like something from a flower shop. He peered in and gasped. Quote, where did it come from? I don't know, Pazit said, but she told him about the car she'd seen pulling away from the curb in front of her house. What kind of car? She got something that wasn't good, somebody like a threatening thing in a box. When she described the old maroon sedan, Billy recognized Twig's car, and the white box might have come from Ashley Flowers. It really wasn't much of a mystery. He knew the people who had done this, not just acquaintances either, his friends. But Billy wasn't ready to tell her that he knew who was responsible. Not yet. He had to think this through. Quote, have you told your folks? She shook her head. Her skin was usually pale, but now it looked ashen. Are you going to? I don't know. I'm afraid all hell will break loose, and I just don't think I can stand anymore. That's the back. We'll look at the flaps here. This is The Drummers of Jerhicho by Carolyn Mayer. Pazit Trujillo could never have imagined just how awful life in Jerhicho would be. For one thing, she quickly learns people in Jerhicho aren't used to outsiders, especially Jewish girls with odd names. Maybe moving from Denver to spend her freshman year of high school with her father and his new family was not such a good idea. Then there's the matter of the cross. Pazit joins the Jerhicho High School Band and learns that the band will play hymns and march in the formation of a cross. Pazit objects, but her objection only inspires hostility and threats. Now Pazit is hurt, scared, and angry, and worst of all, alone. But to her surprise, and even his own, drummer Billy Harper stands up for her. And both Billy and Pazit learn something about friendship and the importance of exercising one's rights. Carolyn Mayer. Carolyn Mayer is the award-winning author of more than 35 books of fiction and nonfiction. Her most recent books from Gulliver Harcourt Brace are Rio Grande Stories, 1994, White Lilacs, 1993, and ALA, Best Book for Young Adults, and, quote, and Where the Broken Heart Still Beats, 1992. An IRA Teacher's Choice, an NCSS CBS Notable Children's Trade Book in the Field of Social Studies, and ALA Best Book for Young Adults. Carolyn Mayer lives in Denton, Texas. This is 1995, this book, The Drummers of Jerhicho. This should be a very good book for children. Now we'll move on for a moment to The Short Life of Sophie Scholl. That's a recommended book for young adults. Get the thing here. Now, we have this. I'd like to read myself one of these days, that the Drummers of Jerhicho. The Short Life of Sophie Scholl by Hermann Vinke. Translated from the German by Hedwig Popker. The Short Life of Sophie Scholl. Let's read from the back. Only 12, when Hitler came to power, Sophie, like the other good German girls and boys, joined the Hitler Youth. But unlike most of them, her spirit and humanity were not crushed by the Nazi machine of propaganda and terror. How Sophie, her brother, and their few friends built a tiny, nonviolent resistance movement is a deeply stirring story of the courage of young people who refuse to go along with racism and murder. Quote, this book is a quietly eloquent affirmation of decency and tenderness that not even brutal totalitarian systems can stamp out. Milton Meltzer, author of Never to Forget, The Jews of the Holocaust. That's a quote by Milton Meltzer. He's the author of Never to Forget, Jews of the Holocaust. Let's read from the inside flap here. With all those people dying for the regime, it is high time that someone died against it. That's a quote. Not 22 years old, Sophie Scholl spoke these words only days before she, her brother Hans, and their friend Christoph Kopst were executed in Munich, Germany for high treason. They had been at the heart of the White Rose, a close-knit underground organization of students dedicated to awakening fellow Germans to the immorality of the Hitler regime in a state where free expression was no longer tolerated. Sophie and the others risked arrest time and again as they covertly accumulated the paper, stencils, and stamps for their angry leaflets of protest. And as each traveled alone throughout Germany to distribute them, so Sophie and the others risked arrest time and again as they covertly accumulated the paper, stencils, and stamps for their angry leaflets of protest. And as each traveled alone throughout Germany to distribute them, they were young and filled with an ardent conviction, never underestimating the danger they were in, but never swaying from their purpose. The Short Life of Sophie Scholl was the recipient of the Buchstuder Bull awarded in Germany to an outstanding children's book promoting peace. It also received Germany's most coveted junior literary award, the German Young Adult Book Prize. In his compelling account, Hermann Vinke has stitched together selections from Sophie Scholl's own letters and diary with recollections by family, friends, and acquaintances. The result is an unforgettable portrait of a life from the child Sophie, creative, dreamy, well-loved daughter of liberal-minded parents, to the highly principled, utterly young woman she became. So this is a book with pictures of Sophie's life, of Sophie Scholl, her life, and it's got some artwork that she did. Here is the picture, one picture here. See what else we have. Various pictures of Sophie, a little girl, Sophie Scholl. That's artwork. Another picture here. Sophie and her friends. Christoph. Other artwork. They made leaflets against the Nazis to try to save Jews at the age of 22, at the young age of 22. There we have The Short Life of Sophie Scholl by Hermann Vinke. That's by Harper and Row. By Hermann Vinke. It's translated from the German by Hedwig Pachter. Let's see what else. We have another book here, a book of stories here. This looks interesting, too. The Cantor's Daughter, stories by Scott Nadelson. He was the author of Saving Stanley, the Brickman stories, The Cantor's Daughter, stories by Scott Nadelson. Let's read from the back here. These stories are rich, involving, and multi-layered. They draw you in gradually so that you become immersed in these characters and their lives, almost without realizing it, an enticing selection. This was a review by Diana Abu-Jabbar, author of The Language of Baklava and Crescent. Here's another quote, another review. The stories in Scott Nadelson's The Cantor's Daughter, set mostly in suburban New Jersey among Jewish families, seize with psychological insight. Nadelson brings a wry and loving eye to the complexity of all relationships and to human failure, in particular to the all-too-common failure to communicate. His characters make fragile accommodations in order to continue living in less-than-optimal circumstances, and he has a striking knack for identifying the perfect, odd, specific, often body-centered details that he then renders with such startling precision that it recasts an entire scene. Kai Emmons, author of His Mother's Son. That was said by Kai Emmons. That's his review. Here's another one. Nadelson, a tireless investigator of the missed opportunity, works in clear prose that possesses a tremolo just below the surface. His narratives about contemporary American Jews are absorbing and satisfying, laying bare all manner of human imperfections and sweet, sad, compensatory behaviors. Stacy Levine, author of My Horse and Other Stories and the Drop. This is a book by Hawthorne Books and Literary Arts, Hawthorne Books. So that's The Cantor's Daughter, Scott Stories, Scott Nadelson, by Hawthorne Books. We'll see what else we have here. We have another book, a book of photography, by Diane Masters. Very interesting book. It's called Diana F. Diana F Plus. More stories, tales, and short stories. This is a book with very nice, nicely colored pastel photographs inside. You can go through them, some of them. Diana F. Very interesting. We'll see in a moment. We'll go through them. Very nicely done, very talented. Some photos at the beach. Very beautiful color. She has to be very talented. Diana F. Plus. Let's go through some more here. Okay. That's wonderful color. Here's some black and white. More at the beach. Oh, that's a nice, cute picture of a boy in a costume. Yeah, we can go through, see if we can go through a few. There we go, we'll get a good taste of the various wonderful pictures we have here. We have a lot of text also here. There's a lot of text. All right, more photographs. Diana F. Diana Masters. Here we have some more. Some nice, I've seen in the back there were some more interesting pictures. hear some more at the beach. Some. Here's some nice photos of the beach. Here we go over here. Here we go. Oh, that's interesting. Some sailors. Very beautiful, very nice talent for taking pictures. Oh, that's a nice picture. And we have a pretty good feel now for the art of Diana F. Diana Masters. So here we go, Diana F Plus. It's called More True Tales and Short Stories. Diana F Plus. And we hope to have more for you next time. Thanks a lot. Thanks for tuning in.